I think I've been always temperamentally a scientist in the sense that I've always just looked at the world and kind of not understood it and wanted to. I mean, you know, look at what's in front of you. You know, what is this? How does it work? Why is it like this? And I can remember even as a very little kid asking quite difficult questions. I particularly remember one incident which, you know, false memory and so on, it probably wasn't like that, but in my memory I think I was about 6 or 7 and I was walking around the pond. We had this big pond in my garden at home and I was kind of plodding around it and I was really worried about heat. What is heat? Because, you know, you can have hot things and the heat goes to cold things, and if you put a cup of tea down, the heat goes away, and where does it? You can't see it, but it's going, you know. And I came to this idea that it was little bits inside moving, that it was movingness, if you like, and that hot things moved a lot and cold things didn't. Now, I have no idea whether it was kind of my original version of that idea or whether I'd heard it on the radio or read it somewhere. We didn't have TV in those days. I have no idea. But that's the kind of question that I asked as a kid. And I can remember later at secondary school asking about animals and why they went around in groups and, you know, all sorts of different questions. And I suppose that's kind of the heart of my life now is exactly the same, you know. I spend a lot of my time just thinking about the difficult questions. But the questions have changed. I'm not interested in heat anymore. I never became a physicist. What did happen was that I went to Oxford to do physiology and psychology. And when I was there, I became interested in the paranormal. And it was almost a whim, really. But it was part of this whole question about, well, what's the world? What's its relation to the mind? And so I became interested in the mind. And I mean, by a long series of accidents, really, I ended up doing the bizarre mixture of psychology and parapsychology that I've done.